I talk about climbing mountains and challenges with, you know, in a race with my dog team, whether it's facing the Topkok mountain range or facing, you know, the Alaska mountain range. But I talk about climbing mountains. And when you run it with a dog team, when you run mountains with a dog team, if they're really steep, you've got to run behind the sled and push the sled. And sometimes, not that the dogs get tired, but I get tired. And if I look all the way to the top of the mountain, I think I cannot run in all this full gear to the top of that mountain in one leg. I just can't do it. So I have to take it in little steps. And I just look down at my feet. So I'm not looking at the whole thing. And when I'm looking down at my feet, I count to 50 steps. And then I can put one foot on the runner and pedal for about 2 seconds. And then the dogs look back like, hey, get off and push. And then I get back off and I start running. I count to 50. But I do it in little steps. And I take that and I take it and I put it in the same mountains I climb in this outside world besides dog sledding. You know, I talk to students a lot about the mountains we all face. And one of the mountains I face is being severely dyslexic. And with that, it's a mountain that nobody can see, but I struggle with it. And I face it just like I do a dog sled race. If I look at this whole form, this whole paper I've got to fill out, there's no way I can do it. I get panicky and I start sweating and I get scared. And it's just a piece of paper. But, you know, papers scare me. But if I take it one question at a time, one step at a time, then it doesn't scare me so bad. And I go, I'm going to climb this just like I do with my dog team, one question at a time, and I'm going to fill it out. But I like to, it's really important to me to encourage people to find your passion. I found my passion when I was 10. I was lucky and blessed. I had the perfect family to help back me. But find your passion and pursue it. It's a long road. It's a long mountain. You know, it took me 15 years to get to the Iditarod. Even though that was a goal I always had, and there were setbacks and times where I thought I'd be able to get to it and things would happen, break collarbones, things like that, and you can't run the Iditarod. And that was my goal. And I thought, you know, at one point I thought, well, I'll never do this. It's too big. There's no way I can get there financially or the dogs or, you know, myself. It's just not going to work. And I realized, you know, sometimes you can't climb a mountain all in one run. You have to stop and rest for a bit. And maybe this is just a resting period I have to take and then keep going. But I just encourage people to climb the mountains in their life, whether it's something, you know, like dyslexia, or maybe it's another learning difference, or maybe it's something physical. But also, when we're out on the Iditarod Trail or any race, our number one priority is taking care of the other people on the trail. If you're in first place and somebody asks you for help, you stop and you help them. And it's the same in, you know, outside in the real world here. If, you know, if you see somebody struggling with something, and maybe that's their mountain, maybe they need a helping hand with that, you never know. Maybe that's something they're struggling with. And later on, maybe they can help you climb your mountain. So that's just kind of what I take out of it.